Sheriff's Department hopes to fill up this truck with items for storm survivors, everything from water and food to bedding and clothing. Some of the people making donations are people who know what it's like to be in need. Joining us this morning is Linda McLaurin, who was down here just a few minutes ago giving some donations. Linda, what brought you down here?
Well, I was a part of the Hurricane Katrina, and we had extensive damages done to our home. And I know how it feels to wake up one day and not know what's your future holds. And I had so much help from the community. I just wanted to give back to the community and give back to the people and let them know that someone cares.
So I saw a bunch of stuff they were unloading from your car. What did you do this morning? Did you just go to the store this morning?
Yes. Well, I didn't realize how extensive the damage was until I saw on television, WABT, and my heart, it just brought back memories, and it made me realize I know exactly how those people feel, and in my small way, I wanted to let them know that I care and that my heart goes out and my prayer goes out to them as well.
My last thing for you, Linda, because you know so well how they feel, what would you say to them right now? If you could be there when they got the water and the canned goods you brought, what would your words be to them?
In spite of the devastation and in spite of what it looks like, hold your head up and the joy will come. And also will be, I will tell them, even though it looks bad right now, what it may turn to be bad, it'll turn around to be a blessing for them. They can start new, build new, and it could bring Mississippi as a whole together. In spite of all the differences, when devastation comes, it brings us together as a community. And to me, that's more important than anything.
That is certainly true. Thank you so much. And words from Linda McLaurin there. Now, the donations she and others are bringing here to the fairgrounds will certainly be of use to folks around Central Mississippi as they start the hard work of rebuilding their homes and businesses today. Reporting from the State Fairgrounds in downtown Jackson, I'm Megan West, 16 WAPT News.